Thank you, Sveta Smirnova, live from us now in Alanya, Turkey. This is the first live section of today, so I'm happy to note that we actually had to interrupt you on your writing answers over Zulip. We have lots of Zulip questions and comments and proposed answers and by both you and others. This is a hot topic. You picked really a hot topic to talk about, Sveta. So, tears. I'm thinking about what the reasons for the tears are. So, would you like to give a, shall we say, overview of the types of the hierarchy of the types of tears? I think that a starting question might be this drop-in thing. What's your view on how drop-in we are in relation to MySQL? As on the other side of the spectrum, you would have to rewrite an entire application. So is it drop-in at all anymore, or just halfway drop-in, or what's your view?
When I'm saying, I'm not saying like you have to rewrite your replication code. It's just like in case if you can very easily to move to MariaDB and use GTIDs. Actually, I like how GTIDs implemented in MariaDB better because they are more human readable. And so I understand what do they mean. It's not such cryptic as MySQL's. But MariaDB server can understand them. But MySQL cannot understand them, and so you cannot, for example, have setups when you have multiple masters and slaves, and you cannot just mix them. You can just like replicate from MySQL source, but you cannot replicate from MariaDB to MySQL if you are using global transaction identifiers. Actually, it's like when I was speaking about tiers, it's like when you use some features and you find out it works a little bit differently and you are surprised, and you are surprised in case when you hit a live application. But if you are prepared, if you know that MariaDB is a similar feature, it works slightly different or maybe not slightly, you can just use it happily and without any issues. Speaking about difference of features, which MariaDB sometimes something which doesn't support, which is MySQL, and vice versa. Del, let's say you chose, and this is like I always tell my customers: you need to find business reasons which features are more important for you for your application.
Right. Yeah. So GTIDs, global transaction IDs, that seems to be the most contested topic, and your view was that it's bad that they are different, or it causes a bit of headache, but they are more human readable in MariaDB, and I'm sure there could be a long debate on which chicken came before which egg and what's important there. So usually drop-in replacement means that you can start a new version of or start a new MariaDB without changing anything. You just shut down the previous version and start the new one. I think there's a frequent comparison here about the size of an upgrade from one MariaDB version to another, or one MySQL version to another, comparing that with upgrading or changing from MySQL to MariaDB. Do you think that is a fair comparison, that you sort of a migration from one version of MySQL or MariaDB to another? Is it the same magnitude?
Assume we are not using specific MySQL functions. This could be compared up to version 5.7. As you saw in the start of my talk, MariaDB uses Area Storage Engine for some tables for which MySQL uses either MySum or InnoDB, and this is why you need to be more careful when running MySQL upgrade. You cannot miss it, but still, probably that's could be compared. It's a different story happens when you want to migrate from MySQL 8.0, which introduced new data dictionary, which is completely incompatible with MariaDB. But
yeah, so what you're saying, I believe what I'm hearing here is that if you want to avoid tiers, migrate when you're still at MySQL 5.7, because you will have tiers if you migrate from MySQL 8, that being based on a different type of storage. So is that a fair thing to say?
Yes, it's a fair thing to say. And also, that's here it's a very interesting situation. When my slides, I wrote that MariaDB has far more collections, different collections than MySQL. But at the same time, default connection collection for UTF-8 character set in MySQL is not supported by MariaDB. And this way, it's even a simple dump from MySQL 8.0 to MariaDB would not work without correction, without changing. So you have to change table collations in default, if you are using default in 8.0, you have to change to another collection set explicitly, only then you can make dump, and only then you can migrate to MariaDB. So this is quite of an extra step.
Yep, so you're saying that, first of all, the major tiers to avoid is the need to have to do a MySQL dump or a MariaDB dump, and all of that is doable or avoidable in all releases of MariaDB and all releases of MySQL up to 5.7. But then it's a case where you cannot migrate from MySQL 8 to MySQL 5.7 backwards either, can you?
Yeah, no, I cannot. Even cannot migrate between, it's not supported, and it's for some version, it's certainly, I cannot migrate from minor versions 8.0, like 8.21 to 8.16, I just cannot migrate.
Yep, so this is a typical thing for a MariaDB person to try to point out, that the incompatibility between migrations from MySQL 8 to MariaDB also exists inside, not just between MySQL 8 and MySQL 5.7, but within MySQL 8 as well. So those would be some highlights. I think the summary here is to do it before or up to 5.7, and especially beware of GTID issues, roles you pointed out. Those are, I believe, of course, less tiers, the roles and stuff, compared to the big picture.
Yeah.
So any final words on how to do that, on top of my sort of overall suggested conclusion from your speech, anything else you wish to say?
Well, it's actually that's it. So I would suggest you just like make sure about like study difference, be aware of them, and take them in account when you migrate.
That's a great summary. Thank you, Sveta Smirnova, live from Alanya, Turkey. Great job.
Thank you, Kai.